In this video, I'm going to talk through two option trading strategies I use during earnings season. I will share with you three of the trades I did this week using these two strategies. I'll tell you how they turned out, as well as the advantages and disadvantages of using each one of them. And at the end, I'm going to share with you the details on one of the three trades I did that went bad on us and explain how we're going to go about fixing that position. Do you trade options during earnings season, or do you avoid them like the plague? That is the question. Personally, I like to trade options during earnings season. Here are two of my favorite ways to do that. If you're looking for a lower risk way to trade options during earnings season, this first technique might be exactly what you're looking for. Here you see an option trade we did yesterday in Amazon. As you can see here in the red box at the top line, we did a bullish put credit spread in Amazon. Notice on the second line that we sold the September 17th, 2950 put option. For that, we received $13.97 per share. Simultaneously, we bought the same expiration day, September 17th, 2650. 50 put option. That cost us $4.97 per share. As a result, we were paid a net of $9 per share for selling this bullish put credit spread in Amazon. But let me back up and show you why we did this trade, why I say that this technique is the safer of the two earnings season option strategies that we use, and why I like using this strategy. Here in the red box, you see that Amazon reported second quarter earnings on July 29th. That was four trading days before we did our option trade. As you can see in the red box, even though Amazon beat their earnings consensus by $2.82 per share, notice what happened to the stock's price. Overnight, the stock dropped over 7.5%. If you had sold put options before this earnings announcement that were anywhere close to the money, you most likely found yourself in a losing position the next morning. We'd been watching Amazon for quite a while, looking for an opportunity to trade options in it. When I saw this big drop, which as you can see here where the white arrows are, put Amazon at the red 200 moving average on the left daily chart, and on the right chart, the big drop put Amazon right at the green 50 moving average. When I saw this, I began watching for Amazon's stock price to stabilize so we could take a bullish position in it. Over the next 3 days, Amazon looked bullish as it slowly climbed, showing that the drop appeared to be a temporary reaction. So yesterday, where you see the red candle with a dollar sign above it, we initiated this position. Just to be safe, we actually sold a pretty far out of the money put option spread. Now I've zoomed out so you can see the strike price that we sold and bought. Where the white line is at $29.50, that's the strike price of the put option we sold. That option was 12.5% out of the money when we sold it. To give ourselves some protection, where you see the yellow line, we bought the $26.50 put option just in case Amazon were to come down in price. So in order for this position to be threatened, Amazon would have to drop over 20% from the price that it was at right before earnings. Now there are no guarantees in option trading, but I can tell you that I like our odds here. I don't see it as very likely that a solid company like Amazon will drop 20% over the next 44 days. I mean, anything can happen. We all know that. That's why we get paid as option traders, to mitigate other people's risk. But I like the odds we're being given here. In all, we were paid $9 per share. We have $300 per share at risk. If you run the annualized return, it equates to an almost 25% return. This, in my opinion, is the least risky way to trade options around earnings. You've already let earnings do their thing. In this case with Amazon, it had a pretty big price drop. This is a strategy that if you wanted to implement it, then you would just check every day to see what stocks reported earnings the previous day. If they had a big price drop and you're long-term bullish on that company, wait for the stock to settle down like we do with Amazon and then sell a put option in the stock. I just sorted my watch list, which contains about 200 companies that we'd be willing to own outright or sell put options in. The red box up top are the ones that reported earnings yesterday, August 4th. The blue box contains the ones that reported earnings today, August 5th. And the purple box towards the bottom is the one company that reports earnings tomorrow. I've drawn arrows to several of the ones that would be potential trades based on the decent price drop today. The goal would be to watch these stocks to settle down, and if they are approaching some type of support, then sell a put option in them. This is a way of using potentially higher volatility because of a big price drop after earnings, while also keeping yourself out of harm's way by not selling options before earnings. The disadvantage of this strategy is that, as you can see, it only allows you to trade options in a small percentage of this overall group of stocks. Out of the 12 stocks that reported earnings yesterday, there are only three real candidates. But the advantage is that you avoid a lot of the potential hazardous price drops that earnings can create. Let me show you a second technique that we use when it comes to selling options around earnings, which actually gives you a lot more potential trading opportunities. Here you see another option trade we did around earnings in the company Lazar, ticker symbol LAZ. Starting on the left side of this rectangle, notice that we sold the August 20th $44 put options. In the next column over, under date, you see that we did this on July 14th. Under the quantity column, you see that we sold 7 put option contracts. In the column to the right of quantity labeled T price, you see that we sold them for $1.15 per share. Lazar is a company that we own outright in our long-term hold account, but also have been selling options in for a long time. As you can see at the far right, the result is that we pocketed $805 for these options. Here you see the chart of Lazar on the day that we sold these put options. Notice it was trading right around $45 per share. I've been watching Lazar for an opportunity to sell more put options in it, and since it was having a nice big down day, I took advantage of that by selling the out of the money $44 put options. This is a company that if it had been put in our account, we would have been happy to own it. As you can see here, it pays a really nice dividend of right around 4%, and it has a business that generates cash flow in every type of market condition, good and bad. It's also a company that has a long track record of being run successfully. As such, this is a stock that I feel comfortable selling options in through earnings. Here's its chart up through earnings day. Notice where the two white arrows are that Lazar actually did go in the money on our short $44 put options. But as expected, it found support at that red 200 moving average. Then a couple of days before earnings, it began to climb. On earnings day, it reached a high of $49 and closed just above $47 per share. As you can see in the red box, Lazar reported and beat earnings on July 30th. As you can see in the far right, after it announced earnings, over the next 2 days, it kept finding resistance at that same $49 per share price. So the third day after earnings, where you see the white arrow, which was actually yesterday, Lazar was looking like it might want to come down in price. So I went ahead and bought those put options back for 15 cents per share, as you can see at the far left of the red rectangle. If you annualize the return for that 21 days that we were in this trade, it equates to a 39.5% annualized non-leveraged cash on cash return or return on capital. Oh, by the way, that capital we freed up by closing out this Lazar position is the same capital we put back to work in the Amazon trade that I mentioned earlier. If that was really useful, what I just shared with you, then I would love it if you just give this video a like. Just bump the like button. And thank you so much for doing that. Now I want to talk you through an options earning trade that went against us in a big way, how it's progressing, and what we plan to do to fix it. Here you see our current short put option that we sold 3 trading days before earnings on July 29th in Amgen. Here's what the daily chart of Amgen looked like on the day we sold that option. We liked that it had been finding support at the red 200 moving average on the daily chart. As you can see here, it had also been finding nice support on the weekly chart at the green 50 moving average. However, earnings was coming up in less than a week. Now this is a company that's been around for a long time, has a nice strong track record of consistently being profitable. So we felt comfortable selling an at-the-money put option in Amgen. For that, as you can see on the far right, under average price, we're paid $4.79 per share. Unfortunately, as you can see here, even though Amgen beat the earnings consensus by 29 cents per share, the next day it dropped down to as low as $227 per share. That meant that the put option we sold was $13 in the money. As you can see at the far right green candlestick today, Amgen actually climbed back up from where it closed yesterday. This is an example of a stock that we sold a put option in right before earnings, were paid nicely for it, but then in response to the earnings, it caused its position to go against us in a big way. So the question is, what are we going to do next? For now, the answer is nothing. As you can see here, looking at the call option at the far left, you see that there's anywhere from 99 cents to $1.17 per share of time value premium left in this call option. This lets us know that there's approximately the same amount of time value premium left in that same strike price, 240 put option. So we still have at least a dollar's worth of time value premium left in that put option. We like to see that the time value gets down to a lot less than a dollar before making a trade to give Amgen a chance to rebound in price. As you can see here at the bottom right of the blue rectangle, Amgen goes ex-dividend on August 16th. That's just 4 days before this option expires. If for some reason Amgen is assigned to us at 240, then we line ourselves up to receive that dividend, as you can see in the top line of the blue box, which is $1.76 per share. We'll then turn this into a covered call position by selling the third Friday of September call option against Amgen. However, if it is not assigned to us before this ex-dividend date of August 16th, then we'll look to roll this option out in time. As you can see at the blue arrow, with this option last trading for $9.20, if we're to lose pretty much all of its time value premium, it would cost us right at $8.20 per share to buy it back. And then if you follow the two red arrows down, you see that we have a couple of roll options to choose from. If we feel like Amgen might continue lower, we'll try and roll the strike price down by $5 by buying to close the August 240 put option that we sold and selling to open the September 17th 235 put option, which should pay us right around $8 per share. And we would use that money to buy back that August option. Or if we feel like Amgen might go back up in price, then we can just roll the same 240 strike price out in time to September, and it looks like we would would net almost $3 per share once the time value is completely gone in the August option. So even though this trade went against us, we're still in a position to win. How will this turn out? Well, we don't know yet. But we do know that within the next 2 weeks, we'll be able to do something with this trade to either pocket some more cash or put the trades in a better or more advantageous position for us. If you'd like to receive alerts as soon as we make trades similar to the trades I mentioned in this video, consider the benefits of becoming a patron at the link in the description below. If you'd like to see more of the tips and tricks that we use as longtime option traders to put the odds of winning in our favor and improve our cash flow, check out the video series in the link above in the description below entitled Trade Options Like a Pro. Until next time, happy investing, and we'll see you again soon.